Hey guys, and welcome back to Action Doom 2. Today I have someone else with me.
Hello, I'm Jade Star.
Oh boy.
So this time we're seeing the last paths and endings of the game. And we're going to the subway without talking to this guy or beating the shit out of him. Which makes things different.
Somehow.
Yep. As you will see.
Hopefully a piece of the trail will land in my life.
First thing first, I'm going to use one of the shits you get at the end of the game, if you have enough score. Which is Dragon Fist.
Sounds exciting.
Yeah.
You're being attacked by shadows.
Yeah, lightning's game is quite retarded.
Sometimes. Yes.
The Dragon Fist, you attack like very fast and hit your tokens.
Wow. That is sure is something there.
That's actually a good shit.
Yeah, I guess. You know, it's a free ranged attack, I guess.
Yeah. And punching's much more effective. Please.
Yeah, you seem to punch faster now.
Yeah, like 2 times faster. Just. You do pain enemies more since you punch more, I guess.
What was she doing in the men's bathroom? Oh,
shit. Didn't you watch this part already?
I know.
Oh, and it's time for teleporting. Oh! Yeah, I already did this, so whatever. Let's go back to the fight. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. We need to fight. Oh, boy. Who cares? Yeah, I want, like, it would be stupid to show, like, 3 times the same levels.
I don't know, Flynn Hagar was pretty awesome, I wouldn't mind seeing him again.
That's true, and someone told me you could get him in the first level, but I didn't know that. And oh boy, so dead already. It's a cutscene.
I can't go on. I can't. I can barely move. I'm beat. I've lost her. A beautiful girl, she's gone far away from here. The trail is dead. She's dead. In my heart, I know. She's dead. I don't get up when the door opens behind me. I don't flinch at the hand on my shoulder. I don't recoil from the tight rein of cold steel pressed against the back of my neck. As I know where she is now, and I'm gonna join her. Soon. Daddy's coming, baby.
Okay, that's it, the end. See you next time.
Wow, that sucked.
So yeah, if you don't know you have to go to Phylex, you die there.
What the crap? You beat up the gay guy, all of his club.
No, you don't beat him.
I know, but you go into his club, you kick everybody's ass, and then
if you die in this fight... Anyway, that happens.
Black. I feel nothing.
This cutscene is long.
Not even the scarce beating.
That's a lot of
I'm unconscious. But I'm alive. When my eyesight returns, I find myself lying in bed, bandaged and naked, sitting in a rundown apartment.
Decide. So thank you. It
takes me a few seconds to become oriented, and I realize I'm not alone. Middle-aged woman, mid-40s perhaps, is entering the room with a bowl. I can smell the aroma from my bed. Gambles. I sit up, my side still leak and I wince with pain. She rushes to my side to help. After my soup, I sit up feeling better and eager to find out more about my host. She lays out the whole story for me, finding my body in the alley behind her house, taking me in and nursing me to health. Apparently it's been almost 2 weeks. She's a warrior. Valkyrie come to my aid. I tell her about my history, how I came to be in her company, the kidnapping, my daughter. I don't know what I've said, but it upset her. Between sobs, she tells me her own son has gone missing. He's been missing a few weeks ago and there's been no word. She says the police have a man investigating, but nothing's come of it save for a small lead. Small lead. That's all I need. She mentioned an old farmhouse in the countryside. Said the officer briefly talked about it. My joints ache, but I bear the pain like so many times before. She pleads for me to stay. Says I need to rest. I don't know what I'll find, but I asked to borrow a car. Tell her to stay behind. I couldn't bear another. Don't talk about your daughter in the past tense, old man. Can't think like that. We'll find her. And if you're lucky, help a friend too. I owe her that much.
So yeah, this is done.
God damn it, Action Doom, what the fuck?
I don't know. But no, in the forest. And there's mines.
Those are mines.
Yeah.
Why don't you step on one and show it off?
I will. Don't worry.
So, if you beat Bebop and Rocksteady, and thus making me miss out on the timing to make a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles joke, you just kind of kick everyone's ass and then spontaneously give up and get shot in the back of the head.
Because you don't know where to go. Oh, and yeah, when you work on a mine, there's a... You say but this, since you work like, if you work again on one, you die.
Luck was on my side tonight, but I better not.
Okay. So yeah, no, you don't know about Phylex because you didn't beat up the car of the gay guy.
But if you do get beat up by Bebop and Rocksteady, you get this whole giant cutscene about some housewife nursing you back to health, and then telling you that her son's gone missing, and there's some random leak.
At least you got a chainsaw, why do you care?
My demand for logic makes me rage.
Yeah, no, if you get beaten up anyway, like if you know about Phylex, if you don't, same thing. Okay, you go at this level. And I'm being very careful because fucking mines. Okay.
This looks like a perfectly normal stream.
Yeah, I guess. Blue Forest.
Just completely ignore the fact it's the only lit area in this entire thing. Just the sun's coming down in this narrow strip.
One sec, it's a secret.
It's the stump from Monkey Island, isn't it?
No. This is awesome. That's
fucking what... Pitfall from Atari.
Yep. It's actually pretty hard to make this jump, though. I died a lot there.
And what, you go the back. Crocodiles?
I don't know what they are, but you jump on them and you don't fall in the wild. That's a pretty... Well, pretty well made. I really liked it. There's a guy that made this mod that was a lot of really good idea, like the casinos, this, and this, I don't know. Yeah, I can actually do one that was mini games too, it's pretty cool. I don't think he. Oh, yeah. 1 proof 7, whatever. Oh, and this part.
Wow, those kind of look like.
Oh, hey, I'm being sniped! Oh no! And
what the hell?
So anyway, whatever you do, you risk you get back behind this. Thing.
Uh-huh.
I know you have to not die from.
Yeah, I think those were supposed to be hail based, but they really look like cinnamon rolls to me.
Yeah, I guess.
I'm also kind of hungry.
Oh yeah, you're right. This. Oh god.
Yeah. I've been up for a while and haven't had breakfast. I was thinking about those delicious fucking croissants I had over in France.
Oh yeah, right, you. But this part is like very easy if you like know how to move fast.
Traffic. If you know how to move fast, is it the W key?
Traffic. No, yeah, you strive.
Oh, so you don't find a gun or a rock or something to kill the guy
you
with?
You kill him though, and that gives you nothing. He keeps out. And now for a spooky house.
Oh, so now instead of Sin City Doom, we're gonna be like Resident Evil 1 Doom.
Kinda. And there's a pretty scout here.
No, this is definitely the farmhouse from Sin City.
I'm gonna need something stronger to break this.
Gas. And you can't break any of these. Stronger to break this. Just like in the first level where you can break the wall. You need some weapon.
I'm gonna need something stronger to break
Wait,
this.
No, I recognize this. It's the farm from Blood Harvest.
No. This thing came
you
much
just gotta
before
go in here, use the radio, and then wait for the army to show up. And
oh,
hey,
dogs. They shout at you, and...
Link?
Yeah, so would name their dog names. Link? And yeah, so it's every hour to fight with any kind of weapons.
Yeah, they're kind of winning. Wolfie.
Yeah. And I believe I'm kinda dead.
Damn, dude.
Don't worry,
you've murdered like 700 people so far, but God forbid a pair of dogs get at you.
No, yes, I've really... GD to fight because they jump around and move fast and shit. So no one said I'm going to go in by the side.
Like that. Uh-huh.
So you can go in the basement here by going this way or by going to the hole in the floor, but you can't see anything. So you have to do this. You have, because you. It's pitch black. Like, yeah, back in the entrance. Yeah, oh. And here, oh. Yeah, back to the room we were before.
Oh, okay, so, yeah, that's.
Oh, there's a something.
There's a button. Very obvious, large. Oh.
Chainsaw or generator? The chainsaw. A choice, isn't it?
Being able to see or weapons.
And oh, of course, weapons. Yes. Both lead to different outcomes. So no, we still can't see. So we have to get back outside.
Maybe the chainsaw will shed some light on your predicament.
It will. First thing first.
Oh, that was quick.
Yep, chainsaw is ultimate weapon in this game. Just.
Oh, right. You needed something stronger to break these things.
Yep. Now for our secret. And you're supposed to find the Necronomicon here, but I couldn't find it for some reason.
Because it's too dark.
Yeah, it's too dark, I agree. And I'm going to run around in circles for a long time because I forgot to get down this crap. So meanwhile, let's talk about something else. So no, yeah, the lightning in this game, I probably hate it for some of the things. It's stylish, but it's either you see stuff shit or you don't. Here you don't.
Did you lose your chainsaw on those Contra commands?
No, I just changed my weapon.
Oh, okay. Because there's things that you could use something stronger to break down with.
That's a water that leads back outside. Why should they care?
I don't know. Anything that's destructible should be destroyed.
This is true. I think I'm going to give up at some point. But no. Nope.
I certainly hope so.
Now I'm going to go up and look there. Yeah, I
was gonna go have a falafel, and then you're like, hey, watch me flounder around in the dark for 10 minutes.
It's not that long, but. No, yeah, I don't know what. Even if you turn the light on, most of these rooms are pitch black, so you can't find anything. I mean, there's nothing to be found in on art, at least.
Wait, the ceiling's dripping blood. I mean, there's a cop car with its light still on, completely abandoned in front of the house. I'm sure nothing's amiss at this place.
Yeah, nothing. But no evidence, so we can break into this.
Ah, yes.
So let's see what's inside.
Oh, yeah, that looks perfectly normal.
Yep.
Also, how is this barn refrigerated?
I don't know, but there's a cutscene.
Through the fog, I see a hulking behemoth striding my direction. He's huge. Goliath to my David. 30 stones easy. He doesn't speak. His heavy brow hides the gaze of his eyes. I sense a rage welling up inside me, greater than I have ever felt. It's time to foul this son of a bitch now. He's huge, but that means he has huge guts. Rip and tear.
Rip and tear.
Oh, come on, really?
So this guy, I believe, is from some gay fighting games like King of Fighters or something. And he's extra strong. He blocks, he percuts you in the face, he has ton of
He uppercutted you off the ground.
Yep. But the chainsaw has can thing.
Oh. Well then.
I strike the corpse's head over and over.
It's a long cutscene again.
Soft chunks and enough teeth for dental identification. Spit on the body for good measure. Feels good. Too good. I find my way back through the woods to the car. I got plenty of time to think about what happened. What I've seen. The worst nightmares of any man. Could not have prepared me for what I saw. How am I going to break it to my savior?
And this part actually doesn't make sense at all because we don't know something. So that's pretty not more made because you have two ways to do things and yeah.
Two complete outcomes or different outcomes.
Different outcomes and you don't learn things and everything in both. So like in this part you don't know why things are reversed because it's something you didn't see and it was a part. Doesn't really make sense to you. Let me see.
That was 10 years ago. Since then, I took a job working in the military camp outside of town, and Mary went back to nursing.
We got two boys, mini Doom guys again. Simon and Nathan.
So, her son's been probably flayed and eaten or something, and you think your daughter's
Did you saw the first video of her daughter went I don't know, it's like, it's a corporate guy who has her.
Yeah, but in this path, you don't even realize that.
Yeah, that's true.
You just kind of assume that maybe your daughter ended up hanging from a barn hook.
But no, because you see her again now.
Oh. She's one of those strong business
types. Coming out from a limousine or whatever. What seemed like minutes was a matter of seconds. We stared at each other and thought we had once known each other. But you're happy and you don't care. Good action.
So you see your daughter, but you just don't do anything about it?
Yep. I mean, it's like 10, 15 years
later. But
she's
gonna be molested by the Dick Cheney guy at Filex.
It's his father. He's a real father. So we'll be back here. I'm going to do the second. Which don't really make sense to, but
the generator way.
I really like the thing on the generator that looks like smiley faces.
Yeah.
So now we
can... They're happy to shed light on the situation with a shovel.
Shovel, yes.
Hey, let's go grave robbing.
Actually, you can't. Aww. First, I want to go back up.
Wait, can we go back to the blue melancholy woods and dig up an ocarina?
No. First, we need to keep the dogs again because I hate them.
Once it's done jumping into the window.
Yep. Take that, Link.
No, we're just gonna leave it dead in the window.
Okay, another thing we missed. So hey, what's up? Missing kids. Oh, and Damn. This guy, I wonder where he is.
What the fuck?
It's a guy who made some art.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's numbered it somewhere, but I don't even. I can't try. I don't know again. So yeah, even here, everything is pitch black, and you get lost very easily again.
Yeah, the numbers are also all missing an area code.
Oh, okay. I don't know that. So we're back here, and to go, since we don't have the chainsaw, we can't break into the farmhouse directly. You have to find another way.
Ah, but we are going to go back to see Hugo.
But on the way up there is...
Uh-oh.
Guessed it. Good. With all my strength, I strike the crumbling rock wall with my shovel. Stones break free and I shatter and fall to the ground, releasing a plume of dust, soil, and concrete. I cover my mouth and cough wretchedly from the debris as I inhale a mouthful of the cloud. After the fog clears, I'm blown away by what lay before me. Tied to an old wooden chair, barely conscious, sits a member of the New York's finest. So lean closer, I notice the badge of Sergeant Johnson. Sergeant Gary Johnson. An old colleague of mine from the force. We used to cross paths in the illegal arms department. I tug his bindings and help him to his feet. He tells me he's investigating a child disappearance when he was struck unconscious and tied up in the basement. Barely alive. He fills me in on what he knows. Whoever lives here is one dangerous, sick son of a bitch. Dozens of cadavers and lost children are kept here. Frozen, buried, eaten. Cannibalism, pedophilia, you name it, it happened. I help Gary back to the squad so he can call for backup. I'm not finished here just yet. For some, incarceration isn't justice. And for others, death is too kind. Here it makes more sense, and that's what you're supposed to get if you don't find the chainsaw at all. But going there is very gay, because you don't know where to go. So you have to go back here and follow this way.
Ah.
And that's why on the side, they don't give you anything on hard, maybe on easy and medium. And we get back here.
Ah.
To the fog, blah, 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 cutscene world. Enough of the
hey,
fight.
Hey, Hugo, what's up? Yeah.
So you have a shovel, you're like, oh, hey, you know, oh, shit.
Did you just break it in one
yep.
swing on his face?
Hard, the shovel breaks in one.
Ah. Well then.
So yeah, that's the hardest fight in the world cooking game. Takes a long time and you have to be very careful. The thing, like, if you go close to him, he does his blocking animation, which is worst, like, part of his attack. You have to stay a good distance from him.
So there's no weapons laying around? Can't,
nope.
Like,
no.
Get a meat hook?
Nope. Nothing.
Beat him with that leg that's hanging behind him?
I wish you could. But no. You have to punch him until he dies. Rip and tear.
Oh, man. We're gonna be here a while.
It's almost halfway down already. I mean, Zardos' thing is not to die.
Yeah, that tends to be the main case in most games in which you
die
is a possibility.
Yeah, but this game usually don't die even against bosses. Like, the one for the bridge was easy, two guys found out.
Now he just looks like a zombie.
Yeah. Look how much time you punched him to get him to this elf. He better have bruises. Come on, die. And he keeps blocking. Oh, no, that's so fucking annoying. But yeah, this guy, armoring, like I said before, he was from some King of Fighters game or something.
I don't recognize him from anything I've played.
It's a console game, I believe, or the game. I don't know anything. I'm sure someone on the right is going to be like, oh, this guy is from here, and...
See, now he's just cowering in fear.
Yeah, look at my elf! One hit and I'm dead. Yes! Fuck you, big guy. Oh, and this cutscene is a buff. Same thing if you kill him with the chainsaw or not. Dental identification.
I spit on the body for good measure. I got the cutscene implies you still have the shovel.
Yeah, I don't. Too good. But this time it's longer. I stumble back to the squad car covered in blood. Gary doesn't ask questions. Just findings, I'm not in the mood to answer them.
After a few minutes, he asks what brought me to the backwoods farmhouse. I fill him in. A woman and a missing son, the kidnapping and my daughter, and the bloodshed on the way. I catch a quick glimpse of Gary's face. It's swollen, bad, and bloody, but I still see it. A look in his eyes that tells me he knows something. He doesn't say much. He doesn't have to. A name, Peter Crisp, head of the Phylex Corporation, my wife's former employer. Find him, he says. And I'll probably find the answer I've been fighting for. Squad car slows to a crawl and stops in front of an enormous pillar of concrete and glass. Gary tells me my business is my own, but he'll have no part in it. Nor does he want to know what I have planned. He drives off into the night until I only hear silence. I find myself standing at the Phylex building. I'll either leave with my daughter, or in a pinewood box. It'll end no other way.
So yeah, we're back at the corporation building again.
Ah.
This doesn't so much make sense because you could have got a choice here, but actually you don't. And that's another shit you get. No, it makes sense because we rescued him. He's not supposed to help us, but we'll force him. There you go.
Oh, he does have a gun.
Yeah. Awesome. It doesn't do much damage with his gun compared to yours, but it's pretty good.
I like how complex it's been to get to the path that explains the most shit.
Yeah.
I kind of expected the, you know, beat the guy's car up, get some information, go there, do that. That seemed like the normal, correct path to go about. But no. We have to do something stupid, die, go to some farm. Save Sergeant Johnson, and now we're back here where we could have been, you know, like three cutscenes ago.
That's right.
Ugh.
And we're back here, and the daughter is here this time.
Looks at me with a bitter rage.
So it's time for the final fight again that I'm going to cut down after a few seconds because it's exactly the same thing.
You didn't notice the flying spaghetti monster poster over there, did you?
What?
He's got four, like, religious looking pictures here. Like,
yeah,
there's
he does.
Paul, I think. Well, the one right there is the flying spaghetti monster over
yeah,
a
yeah,
galley.
Yeah, I'll show you. It's in the elevator part. Is it there? So there's those four swords on the side that's from different games, like, I don't know, Final Fantasy and yeah, I showed the spaghetti monster in one of the elevator doors. Anyway, now it's going to be time for the final cutscene. A few seconds. Oh, by the way, God mode is awesome.
Crisp stares in astonishment. Every hired goon, every security officer, finished.
every obstacle Phylox had at its disposal, every instrument in their arsenal, defeated. No man's gonna stand between my daughter and me. Not now, not after what I've been through. I take a step forward and stop. "Don't hurt my daddy," she says to me. Her words are knives to me. They sting. Even worse than the bullet that tears through my shoulder seconds later. She's holding a small handgun. Two more shots ring out and I'm down. The doctors do everything to save me. Why bother? I'm sitting in my hospital bed thinking about the last months. I'm strung up to a dozen machines, beeping and chirping that tell me I'm alive, at least physically. Inside, I'm already dead. My daughter's spoken. It's not me she wants. I can't blame her. No child chooses a drunk, violent, clinically insane man to take care of you. I hope she's happy with her new family.
He sucks with doctors.
They're so bad.
The doctors are out and the night staff is busy elsewhere. I reach for the bottle of pills next to me. Nobody will complain or raise a fuss about this old man's death.
Bad end.
Oh, god damn it. So, that path, you learn the most info about what's going on, but you get shot by your daughter.
Yep, that's pretty bad, and that was the last path and ending. So the game is done, but we still have one window to go with bonus for this game.
So the game is done, but we still have more game to do.
Yep, so see you there.